Let me get that.
I'm dead tired. Quit acting so chummy.
Then I shall remain by your side. By your leave, Arisen.
Master, I'm not sure how much longer I can keep going without rest.
I only hope we don't encounter any foes. Magics grant you an elemental rune. You have my protection. 'Tis done, Master. Now a fairy stone can whisk us here whensoever we desire.
We've made it, then. What's our first order of business, Arisen?
This ladder looks sturdy enough to climb.
Ah, excellent find.
Yes, sir. Have you procured what I asked? Splendid. You've my gratitude. Unfortunately, I can give you little more than that. Forgive me, but I must return to my rounds directly. Ah, but in place of a reward, mayhap I could give you a tour of the premises. Only if you've the time and inclination, of course. What say you? Would you care to accompany me? As servants of the Gracious Hand, we provide whatever treatment we can to those unfortunate who are stricken by maladies. Yet, at times, 'tis not enough. Perhaps you will recall the parents who were here when you first arrived, an unfortunate pair. They've suffered no few hardships in the slums, and now even their poor son Lubomir has fallen ill. By chance, he was examined by a roaming man claiming to be a doctor. Yet, the family had not the money for the medicine he required. So, he was put into our care.
A fine place to harvest some ingredients.
Shall we see if there's aught to be found while we're here? Here he is. This young man is Lubomir. We've been administering the medicine recommended by the doctor who examined him, but he has yet to show any sign of recovery. To be perfectly honest, I doubt the soundness of that so-called doctor's judgment. After all, there is no shortage of ne'er-do-wells out there, willing to claim their medicine the only cure, that they might inflate its price. But I suppose I ought not say such things so openly. Come, come. We've medicine to prepare. We've enough to make a fresh batch now, thanks to a kind donation.
Psst! You there! Help me! Listen, the sisters here are good to us, but I'm growing weaker day by day. It started with a slight fever, and now I can scarce lift myself up. See that empty bed? An old man was lying in it till just a few days past. He told me he was feeling better, that he'd be well enough to leave anon. And now he's... Mayhap I'm just imagining things. I hope that's the case. And yet... Gah. Something isn't right about this place. Pray, should you hear any queer rumors about the Gracious Hand, come tell me of them, won't you? I'd see to it myself, but I can hardly move.
Very well. I shall go on ahead.
A moment's prayer can do a world of good.
Ah, I'll take that. We might find a use for it.
I've just recalled the little tidbit I heard from the locals.
Regarding the Vermundian military, yes?
Indeed. Tell is, there's been a shift in the chain of command.
Might I beg but a moment of your time?
Each of our patients deserves our full attention. Would that we had more. Might you be a friend of Lubomir's? He's seen better days, hasn't he? There has been talk of sending him down to the basement, should his condition fail to improve. That is, the basement sick room, where our most critical patients convalesce under the Abbess's care. None of the other sisters are permitted entry, including myself. Teliz, she gives the patients a special medicine. I know not what kind. At times I hear strange cries and moans drift up from below. Which is to be expected. Those who come here suffer all manner of afflictions, you see. And yet, a part of me is afeared for them.
So, the worst of us are taken to the basement. Mayhap that's the source of the queer voices I hear at night. And none save the Abbess can enter? If the gracious hand has a secret, 'tis the Abbess who keeps it, I reckon. You've done this much for me. Would you be willing to go further? I must find out what goes on down there. Oh, you've my thanks. I just can't stomach the thought of lying here not knowing. Of course, all the better should your search come to naught. But if you do find aught amiss down in that basement, it must be the Abbess's doing. Should you find evidence fit to implicate her, will you help me see to it that justice is carried out? See, I've already reported my suspicions to the Sentinels, and we've arranged a signal. If you apprehend the Abbess, they'll know to come and arrest her. So I beg you, sir, find the evidence you need, if it exists to be found.
To get to the bottom of what is happening at the Gracious Hand, we shall have to acquire evidence of any misdeeds.
I quite agree.
How might we enter the basement sick room?
Splendid.
I've a modest talent for spotting materials that can be used to enhance your equipment. To get to the bottom of what is happening at the Gracious Hand, we shall have to...
Now seems a fine time to sort through your belongings, Master.
If you feel overburdened, mayhap I could carry some things for you.
Greetings. You need only make a worthy offering in exchange. I have seen your path. May these words guide you true. You've my gratitude. 'Tis lovely to see you. Someone, greetings. You seek guidance, do you not? You need only make a worthy offer. I have seen your path. May these words. You've my gratitude. 'Tis lovely to see you.
There's a ladder here.
We ought to put it to good use.
Forgive me for last night's scuffle.
I lack information pertinent to this task. Consider hiring a pawn better apprised of such matters. We must rest, though the sun is still up.
The Goblin's lair lies somewhere along the Western Road. I hope you can reclaim aught from the fiends. 'Twould bring me peace of mind to know someone taught them a lesson at least.
How might I be of service? Welcome to and quality is what you need if you want to survive. So before you check the price, so just remember, misers die early deaths. Hope to see you again.
Our packs are ahead. Via, and our purse is far lighter.
How might we enter the basement sick room?
Splendid.
Greetings. Here we conduct all manner of procedures pertaining to vocation.
Have you found any of the items we... just perchance.
always a pleasure.
There is much we ought to tend to, if we are to strengthen your Majesty's claim as a true arisen. Of all those who serve the Queen Regent, there is but one who I have no doubt will lend his support to your Majesty's cause. I refer to Waldar, a magistrate. Many a time Adiza demanded Waldar amend the Code of Vermont to her own benefit. And many a time as the magistrate refused her, for he is loyal to none but the spirit of the law. As a result, he now sits in a cell beneath the palace. Our laws dictate that your majesty is our rightful ruler. Thus, as the staunchest supporter of the law known to the palace, I'm quite confident that Waldor will be willing to vouch for your majesty. What say you? Might you be willing to aid me in arranging the magistrate's release? I've prepared a means for you to enter the palace dungeons. Pray, take this. This mission demands the utmost secrecy. Prithee, be cautious, your majesty. Should you be discovered, I will be unable to lend aught in the way of aid.
I can accompany you to the castle entrance, Master, but no further.
Very well. I shall return.
Thank you. shall remain here.
I really would have been better off a baker. My legs are stiff as boards after training.
Not sure why I patrol it, if I'm honest.
I'd kip just about anywhere. Must hold out till someone comes to relieve me. Do not test me. No easy.
easy thing.
I'd hasten home, were this not my duty.
As soon as my shift's done, I'm off to the tavern.
You impudent little!
Have you come to release me from this jail? Who are you? Oh, then we are presented with three options. Either the law of our world that allows only one arisen has been upended, or Deezer's arisen is false, or you are lying to me. Have you proof that you are arisen, as you say? Ah. They say the Arisen's breast bears a wound akin to the dragon's claw. By that mark, 'twould seem 'tis true. This reminds me of a happening 148 years ago. During the reign of Regent Alphonse, a man named Crusoe appeared and claimed to be Arisen. He went before the people, insisting that he, and not Regent Alphonse, was the true Arisen, the one fit to lead them as their ruler. And what befell him, you ask? Ha! Crusoe was discovered to be a liar, whereupon his head was liberated from his shoulders on the spot. Aye, I dare say your arrival portends another beheading, but whose will it be, Escape? But why? Here, I spend my days perusing the code and deciphering old texts. I can devote all my time to my own interests. And I need not turn my ear to Deesa's absurd demands. 'Tis a paradise to me, this cell. That said, if you know of a place with a mountain of tomes I could delve into, I might rethink the matter. Tell me, does that ring any bells? Oh, to think such a place existed. How very curious. Guide me outside, then. If you can deliver me from this pit, I ought to be able to find the rest of the way on my own.
What?
I have been waiting for you, Arisen.
You are in need of peace.
Aye, this should be far enough. My thanks. If you truly are Arisen, then I swear to someday repay this debt I owe. Words may be wind, but there's naught else I can offer you at present. Pray visit me if you've the time or inclination. Mayhap the knowledge I've gained reading tomes of Eld could be of some use to you.
A door of sturdy make. 'Twill be impossible without the key.
We must needs find the key.
Thank you.
Why I came.
Take opportunities as they come, I say.
Not a care in the world. Just as a
predicament.
There is much we ought to tend to, if we are to strengthen your majesty's claim as a true arisen. It seems Magistrate Wardour has been safely delivered from his cell. The man's dedication to justice shall doubtless be a great boon to our cause. Mayhap it would be prudent to visit the man on occasion and avail yourself of his vast stores of wisdom. He might have knowledge that could benefit you on your travels. Now, would you be so kind as to return the key I lent you? I thank you. Pray, take this. Consider it remuneration for your Majesty's efforts.
That was certainly worthwhile.
A laudable result. Just what I would expect of the Arisen.
Our efforts have been rewarded.
There is much we ought to tend to. We are to strengthen your Majesty's claim, as for some time now, 'twas said that the false sovereign was recovering from his battle wounds. But as I hear it, he is now well enough to walk unaided. And so, in honor of his supposed valor, they have been holding masquerade in the palace of late. The false sovereign's identity is still beyond our ken. Even the matter of from where he hails remains a mystery. But mayhap approaching the false sovereign at one of these gatherings could afford you a glimpse into the man behind the mask. What say you, your majesty? Might I ask this task of you? My thanks. Some of the sentries posted at the masquerades are under my command. I shall have them ease security. So pray, slip into the venue through whatever opening presents itself. Once your infiltration is successful, you will need only don a mask and act the part of an invitee. Few will think to be wary if they believe you a fellow masquerader. Here, this should suffice to help you blend in. Take care, your majesty. Ah, there is one other thing. Masquerades being as they are, you will require suitable raiment. Much is made of appearances at such gatherings, and 'twould be wisest to dress the part when joining the other revelers.
Would you mind coming over here?